I have no headache. I am usual self. I went through the same thing when the process of choosing a girl for me was going on. But I don't think that could be a reason for your present condition. Ranga stared at me. Come, let's go and see Shastri, I suggested. We will find out whether Guru and Shani are favorable for you or not. Ranga accompanied me without any protest. As soon as Shastri saw me, he exclaimed, what a surprise. Shyam, haven't seen you for a long time. Now Ranga insists that everything is fine with him. Now, narrator very wittily makes a remark that he went through the same feeling when he was seeing girl for himself and immediately mentioned that it couldn't be reason for Ranga. Now furthermore, he suggested that he go see Shastri to see if the stars are in their favor. Ranga went with him. On seeing Shastriji, he implied not having seen the narrator in a long while, which is obviously not true, as they had met before the same morning. Now, Shyam is none other than your servant, the narrator of this tale. I got angry and shouted. What? Only this morning Shastri completed my sentence. You finished all your work and are now free to visit me. Had he not done so, I would have ruined our plan by bursting like grains that are kept in the sun to dry. I was extremely careful of what I said afterwards. Shastri turned to Ranga. When did young son of your accountant clerk come home? What can I do for him? It's very rarely that he visits us. Now, here narrator reveals his pet name Shyam, as they called him in the village. Narrator felt Shastri was lying because they saw each other that morning and thus immediately responding. However, Shastri completed his sentence and saved the entire situation. Shyam realized that he was just about to do and took extra care from the moment. Shastri continued his role and acted surprised on seeing Ranga. Take out our paraphernalia. Our Rangappa seems to have something on his mind. Can you tell us what's worrying him? Shall we put our science of astrology to test? There was a thought in my voice as I spoke to Shastri. He took out two sheets of paper, some cowries and book of Palmyra's leaf, saying R is an ancient science, Aya. There's story to it, but I wouldn't tell you that story now. This is not Harikatha, which allows you to tell a story within a story. You may get bored. I will tell you to some other time. Now, the narrator asks Shastri to take out all his tools to help solve whatever is going on in Ranga's mind. Shastri took his essentials and told them that this is all ancient science, but he wouldn't recite it now because then they both would get bored. But he does intend on telling it some other time. Shastri moved his lips as fast he counted on his fingers and then asked, what's your star? Ranga didn't know. Never mind, Shastri indicated with a shake of his head. He did some more calculations before saying it serious tone. It's about a girl. I had been controlling my laughter all this while, but now I burst out laughing. I turned to Ranga. Exactly what I had said. Who is the girl? It was your humble servant who asked the question. Now, Shastri moved his lips while counting quickly. Shastri implied that it is manageable. He appeared to be doing certain calculations, and after a moment he indicated that Ranga had a girl in her mind. In his mind. Even after trying his best, Shyam couldn't control his laughter. Next is, I had been controlling my laughter all the while. I had been controlling my laughter all this while. But now I burst out laughing. I turned to Ranga exactly what I had said. Who is the girl? It was your humble servant who asked the question. Shastri thought for a while, replying, she probably has the name of something found in the ocean. Kamla, maybe. Could it be Panchi? Pachi Moss. Must it be Moss of? It's not Kamla. Why not Pearl or Ratna? The precious stone, Ratna. The girl in Ram Rao's house is Ratna. Tell me, is there any chance of our negotiations bearing fruit? Definitely. He said, after thinking for some time, there was surprise on Ranga's face and some happiness. I noticed it. But the girl is married, I said. Then I turned to him. His face had fallen. Now, Shastri thought and replied, the girl is likely to have name of something found in ocean. All of it came together now to a girl named Ratna. Ranga was thinking about her only. Ranga was both surprised and happy because Shastri's prediction were right. He immediately became suffering from disappointment. He immediately suffered from disappointment when he recalled that she was married. Next is, I don't know all that. There may be some other girl who is suitable. I only told you what Arshastra indicated, Shastri said. We left the place. On the way, we passed by Ram Rao's house. Ratna was standing at the door. I went in alone and came out a minute later. Surprising, this girl isn't married, it seems. Someone told me the other day that she was. What Shastri told us has turned out to be true. After all, but Rangappa, I can't believe that you have been thinking of girl, of her, swearing on the name of Madhav Charya, and tell me it true what Shastri said. I do not know whether anyone else would have been direct, Ranga admitted. There's a greater truth in that, Shastra, than we imagine. What he said is absolutely true. Now, Shastri said that he didn't know all that. There might be another suitable girl. To make it look real, Shastri inferred in their name guessing game and told them that he... Now, both of them left and crossed Ram Rao's daughter's door. When Shyam went to see Ratna for a minute and come back, narrator comes back. He announces that fortunately Ratna is not married and someone might have wrongly conveyed. Now narrator expresses his amazement at the fact that he had been thinking about Ratna and ask him to swear upon the truth. To his surprise, Ranga told him truth that whatever Shastri said is true. His belief in all the Shastras had strengthened. Now, Ranga ne admit kiya narrator ke samne ki wo kya hai? Ratna jaisi girl hi chahte hai. Means Ratna se hi shaadi karna chahte hai. Aur uski jo शास्त्री ने जो भविष्यवाणी की थी कि एक ऐसी गर्ल है जो उसके माइंड में है, जो उसको क्या है, सारा दिन उसके बारे में सोचता रहता है, वो शायद रत्ना ही है. और वो क्या बोलता है कि शास्त्री जी की भविष्यवाणी सच है. और वो नरेटर को बोलता है, और नरेटर क्या बोलता है कि मे बी किसी ने मेरे को गलत कन्वे किया था कि रत्ना जो मैरिड है वो क्या है, अनमैरिड गर्ल है. नाउ शास्त्री वॉज एट द वेल व्हेन आई वेंट देयर दैट इवनिंग, सेड सो शास्त्री गेल. यू रिपीटेड एवरीथिंग आई हैड टॉट यू विदाउट गिविंग राइज टू एनी suspicion. What a marvelous shastra yours is. He didn't like it all. And what you are saying, what you said to me was what I could have found out myself from shastras. Don't forget, I dwelt on the hints you have given me. Tell me this, what a decent man says. Now Shyam went to see Shastri that evening when he was near the well and remarked about how well he did what Shyam told him to do. Now Shastri seemed to not like what the narrator was saying. Thus he says that whatever he said could very clearly be seen in the Shastras. He completely disagreed with having staged the entire conversation. अब क्या है, वो उसको मिलता है शाम को, शास्त्री को बोलता है कि थैंक्स तूने वही बोला जो मैंने बोलने के लिए कहा था तेरे को. और वो क्या बोलता है, नहीं मैंने तेरा बोला हुआ नहीं बोलना, जो मैंने सारा कुछ देखा कुंडली में वही बताया है कि वो क्या है सच में ही उसको पसंद करता है. और वो साफ साफ उसकी कुंडली में लिखा हुआ है. Rangappa had come the other day to invite me for a dinner. What's the occasion? I asked. It's Shyam's birthday. He is 3 and it's not a nice name, Shyam. I said, I'm like a dark piece of oil cake. Why did you have to give that golden child of yours such a name? What a childish couple you are, Ratna and you. I know. It's English custom of naming the child after someone you like. Your wife is 8 months pregnant now. Who's there to help your mother to cook? My sister has come with her. I went there for a dinner. Shyam rushed to me when I walked in and put his arms around my legs. I kissed him on his cheek and placed a ring on his tiny little finger. Now, the narrator takes a few years forward this story, where Ranga and Ratna happily married and had a 3-year-old son, and Ratna was 8 months pregnant and Ranga's sister had come to help them. It was Shyam's birthday. Yes, the couple named their son after narrator, as it is common for an tradition to name your child after someone you truly admire. When the narrator went there for a dinner, Shyam came running to him only to show his love by holding his leg. Narrator kissed him and gave him a ring. Allow me to take leave of you, reader. I am always here, ready to serve you. You were not bored, I hope. Now, narrator writes an ending note to all the readers, hoping that they were not bored. Now, this is all about the chapter. I hope you understand this chapter well. Thanks.